What's up, everybody? Prestige here, and holy crap, we're back on Advanced Warfare. And yes, that is an M1 Garand that you're looking at right now. This is a new weapon that was added to Call of Duty Advanced Warfare yesterday on the Xbox One. My mind's blown. You gotta think, the game's been out for a while now. Black Ops 3 is currently in the limelight, but the developers at Sledgehammer Games are still adding support for this particular game. And I will say this, I was having a blast using this thing. It's a lot of fun. It's a true remake of the World War II M1 Garand. It's a lot of fun, and I absolutely love using it. You can find it in supply drops, stuff like that on the Xbox One, but this thing is nice. So what I'm going to be showing you in this gameplay is the royalty version. I'm also going to be showing you the royalty version with the suppressor, and then at the end of the video, I'm going to be showing you the base model, close quarters, speed reloading, stuff like that. It is a lot of fun. But let's start things off by saying this rifle seen its service from 1936 to 1957, and it was the standard US service rifle. Even in Advanced Warfare, you can hear that distinctive pinging noise once you run out of ammunition and the clip ejects itself out of the weapon. Now, one thing that you can do with Advanced Warfare that you can't currently do with the MX Garand in Call of Duty Black Ops 3 is reload at will. You can reload whenever you want, but it's going to take a little bit longer than if you were to just run out of ammunition normally. So if you wanted to manually reload, it takes about an extra second as compared to just letting the ammunition run out by itself and letting it do its thing by itself. But if you really wanted to reload faster, you could do a speed reload, dumping everything in your current clip and, of course, inputting a new one, and that is the quickest possible way. Now, you can't get fast mags for this thing, you can't get anything like that that didn't exist in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, but this is still a pretty awesome weapon nonetheless, and it still is very effective. I noticed at super long ranges it could take 3+ shots to kill, at close ranges it could be 2 shots to kill, and it's just really balanced overall, I feel, as a weapon that integrated itself into the game so late into the game. Now, one thing Advanced Warfare was always infamous with was suppressors. Putting on suppressors and severely cutting the range and the damage that you do at a range with the weapon. And I've noticed that there's no difference with this and the M1 Garand. If you're trying to use the suppressor on this weapon and somebody's at a super long range, it could take 4+ shots. And that's not a valuable thing to have, especially when there's only 8 rounds in a clip. There's no extended magazines that you can put on this. So being able to effectively use all the rounds on multiple enemies or somebody that's within your vicinity, it's just not going to happen when using a suppressor. Now, if you're at closer ranges, of course it's going to be a little bit easier to use, but anything at super long distances or just long ranges period, it's going to take 4+ shots, and that's just not something that you want. The base model of the M1 Garand is just a lot of fun to use. It has that classic wood grain finish. It looks exactly like a World War II M1 Garand, and it's just a lot of fun. Like I said before, you got a pretty high damage amount, you have pretty high accuracy, you don't necessarily need to use a foregrip, and one thing that I would never recommend is using a red dot sight or anything like that. Sure, it's gonna help you if you really wanted to aim down sights, but if you want to do yourself a favor, you have to use this classic. You have to use it straight up. No red dot sights, no thermal sights, nothing like that. Keep this thing classic, pair it with the MP40 in Advanced Warfare, use the overkill or something, and just do yourself a favor and go to the shooting range with this iron sight. It's beautiful, it sounds beautiful, and I'm even gonna step on some toes here, but I think that the reload sound, that distinctive ping that comes out of the weapon, sounds even better than the MX Garand in Call of Duty Black Ops 3. Enemy UAV. I don't know why, it just sounds really good, and I'm sure that you guys can hear a distinct difference as well. But that's just what I wanted to say about this particular weapon. I think that it's a lot of fun to use. It's really interesting to see that Sledgehammer Games is still supporting the game to this day. So perhaps we might see some more weapons coming soon. If that's the case, I can't even imagine what they're going to be adding. But another thing that I really was starting to think about was something that was in the game and then cut from the game towards the end was the supply credit system. Maybe we'll be able to see the supply credit system make their way back. If that's the case, that would be awesome for anybody that has a huge armory just filled with a bunch of duplicates like myself. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this step back into the future. That sounds kind of weird, with Advanced Warfare. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to click the like button down below. I absolutely love the M1 Garand. I love everything about World War II and just stuff like that. So being able able to get my hands on this and play with it is just a lot of fun. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to click the like button down below and subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace. Thank you so much for joining me at the end of the video. If you missed yesterday's video, we did a hero gear guide for Seraph. Make sure to click on the link on the screen right now. And if you would like to subscribe on over to my second channel, please feel free to click the annotation on the screen or down below in the description and hit the subscribe button over there. Until tomorrow, guys, I'll see ya.